Hey guys, Joseph here. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video. So this time I'm getting ready to go to CES this 2020. I've been going to see the CES for the last couple of years, and every time I go, there's always something new. Of course, this is where all the tech companies show off what's new, what's coming up. Sometimes they do come out, sometimes they don't come out. So let's see what's going to happen this year with Sony, LG, TCL, VCO, what else I'm missing? Sony, Samsung, of course, Samsung. All right, guys, so let's get right into this video. Let's do this. All right, guys, so let's get right into this because I already seen some articles that LG has already unveiled their new 8K OLED and LCD TVs at CES this year. So I'm looking forward to see this. Although I just want to say I'm not excited about 8K TVs. I just feel like I don't know why these companies are focusing on 8K resolution when there's still a lot of people who haven't even buy a 4K TV. You know, they're still with full HD. They just don't believe it. They just feel like all this 4K HDR is a joke. They just don't believe it. So now these companies, they're jumping into 8K. I mean, I don't even believe it. But anyways, let's go and find out how these TVs are going to look. And it's funny how LG and Samsung have this fight going on for quite some time already. So of course, I'm going to read to you a little bit of this article from The Verge, or in Spanish we call it La Verge. But anyways, if you want to find out more about this article, I'm going to leave a link at my Facebook page, Jolster G4K Facebook. You can find it right there. There's a link to my Facebook page. Follow up because I'm always posting these links that I think they're very interesting. And The Verge is talking about how, I'm going to read to you a little bit, all right? So LG has announced 8K TVs ahead of CES. There are two OLED models, which are 77 and 88 inches. Wow, that's 88 inch OLED TV. Imagine how cool that will be. I have an 80 inch screen for my projector. This is an ALR screen, which looks fantastic for the size of room I have. But imagine this screen in OLED. Isn't this gonna look pretty damn awesome? But one thing for sure is that OLED TVs are very thin, so having that, you know, that thickness, though, or as a matter of fact, thin in that size, I think there's going to, this has to have something solid, something heavy in order to, you know, handle that screen, because it's so thin. I feel like it's gonna break, but it will be interesting to see how the engineers figure this out. So anyways, if you want to have a 77 or 88 inch OLED, this is going to be something new by Samsung. The article keeps reading, and six LCD measuring 65 and 75 inches. So I noticed that LG, I remember LG was giving up on LCDs, but I guess this year they're still going on. They're going to focus more on OLED, that's for sure. LG is yet to announce pricing or availability information for any of the sets, but is keen to emphasize that they're all offer real 8K. So there's a war between LG and Samsung. Like, LG is claiming that they have the real 8K and Samsung is fake 8K. I'll tell you right, you'll find that right now. In what appears to be a shot across the bow at Samsung and its recently announced certification from the 8K Association. That's what I was talking about. Watch this. The announcement marks a continuation of LG's proxy war with Samsung over what exactly constitutes an 8K TV. While both companies agree that 8K is a resolution of 7,680 horizontal pixels by 4,320 vertical pixels, the two companies have different ideas about how this should be measured. LG uses the Consumer Technology Association's definition, which relies on a measurement called contrast modulation to define its pixels. Meanwhile, Samsung uses the 8K Association definition. It's an organization which LG is not a member of, which doesn't list any such requirements. So in this case, So LG and Samsung, they're using different associations to define the measurements. They haven't even figured that out, how to measure the pixels on this TV. But honestly, I feel like I try and lean more towards LG because it just makes more sense. And the Samsung's AK association, it just they don't have any requirements. So that to me, honestly, that doesn't make any sense. All right, guys, so let's see how that turns out. But also another thing that I found out from LG is that they're probably working on a foldable TV. Yes, a foldable TV. Now you notice that phones, the new phones are coming out with foldable phones and everything, but a foldable TV. So LG supposedly is working on this, and it looks freaking crazy. It looks weird, but you know, maybe it will help some people. It'll work for some people. I don't think it's going to work for me, but who knows? So pretty much this TV folds like a one of those Japanese room divider, and it expands to a full-size TV, and each end is where it's going to have the speakers, and they're going to serve as the stands. It's going to be a 21 by 9 screen and can fold as much as compact as a package when not in use. But this is going to be very, very crazy if we see this. You know, this is going to be like an foldable OLED with a built-in sound bar as well. That is crazy. I'm looking forward to something like this. I like it when technologies, when I like it when companies experiment with different technologies, with different crazy ideas, because who never knows? Maybe this is not a great idea, but it'll something good will come out of this. All right, guys, so now let's jump into what is Samsung doing, what is Samsung working on. And one thing for sure is that now Samsung has finally made up their mind in working into the OLED section of technology. They realize that LCD, the market, it's oversaturated with LCD technology or TVs. So they're finally making that jump, but that's not it. They're combining their quantum dot technology with OLED. So they're going to call it QD OLED, which is crazy because usually, I mean, OLED already looks beautiful, right? And now they're mixing quantum dots. So I'm very interesting to see how this is going to turn out. But honestly, I don't know if we're going to see this at CES because this is just like very, very new. And I think Samsung is still working on their manufacturing of this OLED TVs, OLED panels. But who knows? Maybe we'll see something at CES. I'm looking forward to see this. And I'm excited about this new QD OLED TVs. And of course, Samsung, they have this frame TVs already. So if you want a TV that looks like a beautiful portrait or frame, they have that already. They have the Serif, and they're coming up with the new, the Zero, they call it, which is pretty much like a vertical position. I think this is great for business. I don't think this is going to be good for me, but I think it's going to work out really good for businesses. So another really, really cool and exciting thing is the next gen TV, or this is pretty much the new technology that is called ATSC 3.0, which is going to be delivering 4K picture over the air. Now the new, you know, broadcasting TV is going to have finally 4K resolution for all of you guys who have a brand new 4K TV. So this is going to be completely free, just like when they did it with 720p or 1080p. And some of the new TVs, especially I think LG already announced that it's going to have this hardware in some of their new TVs. So this is pretty awesome because I notice a lot of people who buy a brand new 4K TV and they'll get all excited. Finally, they're going to have a beautiful picture. They go home and they start watching the regular TV and it looks like crap. It looks bad. You know, so what happens is that when you buy a brand new 4K TV, you need to have also the format. You need to have the Blu-ray player that is, you know, compatible 4K, also a 4K movie. Or if you have, if you're streaming, you need to have the service that is high resolution or 4K with HDR. Same with gaming. You gotta have the Xbox One X in order for you to play 4K games. So a lot of people, they don't know this, and they just think that their over-the-air channels are gonna look beautiful just like at the store. And it turns out that is not the case. So this is going to help all of these people to better understand, to get better picture quality over-the-air channels. So this is great. Hopefully we'll see more of this. All But this is another technology that I'm looking forward to see. Another cool announcement from Samsung is their new monitors. Guys, you know I have reviewed some of these monitors, some monitors here on my channel. So this is the new G9 and the G7 curved QLED gaming monitors. There are 1000R curvature and superior performance that gamers demand. Man, these monitors look freaking amazing. And they're going to have this curve. Look at this curve. It is crazy curvy. This is going to be, the G9 is going to be a 49-inch. So you guys have seen those huge 49-inch monitors, but now they're going to have a more curvatory display. Look at this. This is going to be huge. And it also has this blue ring in the back, which looks really impressive. This is going to be a 5120 by 1440 resolution with an impressive 240Hz of refresh rate, 1 millisecond of response time. This is going to have a 1000R curve, 1000 nits of peak brightness. This is going to be really good for HDR, of course. And there's going to be different versions. So this is the 49-inch, which honestly, this is too big for me, but it will be nice to test it, to try it. But then the G7, they're going to have a 32-inch and a 27-inch version of the G7. These are going to be VA panels, and they're also going to be same 2560 by 1440p resolution with HDR 600, which is pretty much like 600 nits of peak brightness. This is good. I like this. And they're also going to feature quantum dot. They're going to have G-Sync. They're going to have FreeSync. So they're going to be pretty much everything. Hopefully, I don't see if they're going to be HDMI 2.1. I didn't see any information about this, but hopefully they are, because this is going to be great for the new consoles. And I wish this would be just like 4K at least, but you know, playing on this type of monitors, it still look beautiful, it still look great. I'm looking forward to one of these monitors. Now moving forward to TCL. TCL is going to bring their new or next generation of mini LED TVs, which looks very similar to the one they already brought this last year. I mean, it just barely released. So usually I notice that TCL, they are probably like the last company to release their new models. So they released it almost like by the mid of year or by the end of the year. But you know, I've seen a lot of videos and from the first new mini LEDs, and it's not that great. They haven't been very positive. They say they have problems with contrast and there's a lot of blooming. So hopefully, you know, hopefully TCL will be able to fix this. But honestly, guys, if you bought a mini LED TV from TCL, the cheapest one was $2,000. So hopefully TCL updates, they do a firmware update on those TVs, because I don't think it's fair to buy another mini LED TV and just when you just bought one. You know, I don't think it's going to be that fair, but I don't know. Hopefully TCL does that. But mini LED looks very promising. Mini LED is pretty much something in between micro LED and LCD LED TVs, which is supposedly going to be really bright panels with really good contrast. So hopefully these new LCDs or LED TVs from TCL, they come out much better than last year's. And I'm also looking forward to see how they're going to, their new 6 series is going to be looking, because this is the 8 series. Mini LEDs are only available in the 8 series. So maybe they implement this technology into their 6 series. So maybe that's what's going to happen on their new 6 series from TCL. But let's see what happens. We'll find out in just a few more days. So of course, when you buy a brand new TV, the next thing to do is to buy a sound system or a soundbar or receiver. In my case, I use a soundbar, which is sitting right here. I have the Nakamichi Elite. This is a Shockwave Elite 7.2.4, which is awesome. It has dual subwoofers. It has rear surround speakers. It supports Dolby Atmos, Dolby Vision, DTS:X, HDR10. I mean, it has everything, pretty much everything. But Klipsch is coming out with their new models on 2020, which they look very promising too. But One thing I noticed over here is that the prices, they're not very price friendly. And they do offer, there are two models that they do offer: Dolby Atmos, DTS:X, Virtual X, and 12-inch sub wireless subwoofers and a dedicated surround 3 with Dolby Atmos speakers. I mean, they do offer some really cool hardware, and they also are including EARC connectivity. And some of them, they also have HDMI 2.1. Well, as a matter of fact, if they have EARC, they're automatically pretty much saying that they support HDMI 2.1, which this is going to be very, very good for, people who are looking forward for HDMI 2.1, or if you have an OLED TV from this year or this last year, like a C9 or a NanoCell TV from 2019, you should already have HDMI 2.1, which is something that my soundbar is missing. So hopefully Nakamichi gives me an update for HDMI 2.1. Let's see what happens. They're also going to have Wi-Fi, and I mean, for example, this one, the top of the line from Nakamichi is going to cost $1,500. That is crazy. That's a lot of money. This other one right here, the middle class, the middle tier, is going to cost $700. Just the soundbar and the subwoofer. If you want the surround speakers, there's going to be an additional $289, which is going to make like $1,000, which is almost pretty much the same as this soundbar. The difference is that this soundbar has two subwoofers, which makes a huge, huge difference. That's why I love this soundbar, the Nakamichi. It sounds excellent. Then lastly, the bar, the 44-inch bar, comes with an 8-inch subwoofer, and this one doesn't support Dolby Atmos or the DTS:X, nothing. And this one is going to cost $500. So these are the new soundbars by Klipsch. If you like that brand, if you're looking forward for a soundbar, this might be a good option. But honestly, guys, like I said, I've been using this soundbar from Nakamichi, and it sounds excellent. I love it. I highly recommend it to you. So that's it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for stopping by, and remember to stay tuned because there's gonna be tons of new videos from CES. CES is so big. It's not only about TVs. There's going to be cameras, drones, virtual reality, speakers, even car technology. There's like so many things that's going to be in there. I'm gonna try to cover more than just TVs. Yeah, robots. So I'm gonna try to cover almost everything. But also let me know in the comment section, what are you interested in looking or seeing? Something that you want me to cover, let me know in the comment section, because I'm only going to be there for like about 3 days, so it's not going to be enough time to cover everything, but I'll try to do my best to cover the most interesting things or something that you guys might want to see. Oh, I didn't cover Hisense, right? Or Vizio. Oh, man, there's so many things, but I don't want to make this video too long. So thank you guys for stopping by. I'm Jolster. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Jolster out.